So the first thing we will take note of when we are curious about a tree's species is the bark. Some trees have such a unique bark that this one feature alone can almost completely guarantee its identity. Cherry bark, for example, which some say looks akin to burnt cornflakes, is pretty distinct from other species. Next up, we can take a look around and under the tree to see if there might be leaves or fruits remaining about. Any leaves found at this time of year tend to be quite dried up and might not assist us very much in identifying the tree. But certain fruit remnants, such as maple keys or black walnut shells, can provide us with great hints as to who produced them. On to the buds. These small little clusters are waiting for the right time of year to burst open and produce new leaves for the tree's next annual cycle. They are unique to each species and can help us to tell one from the other. First, we look to the orientation of the buds and branches. Do they develop from the same point of a branch, just in opposite sides? Or do they stagger up the branch with one here, the next up there, back and forth, and so on? There are many more trees with what we call the alternate arrangement than there are those with opposite, and noting this detail can help us to eliminate several different possibilities either way. Maples, ashes, dogwoods, except of course the aptly named alternate leaf dogwood, have buds and branches that are arranged in an opposite orientation. If you can remember the acronym MAD, this will help you to narrow down which species you could be looking at. Let's look closely at these buds, too. What color are they? What shape do they have? Are they rounder and a little bit on the plump side? Or are they skinny and pointed? Are they long and tapered? Do they look a little like an ice cream cone? Or like a spade from a pack of cards? We've included a PDF chart, which we hope will be a helpful visual reference for the different barks and buds of some species you might come across in your own neighborhood.